and today we're going to be talking about propagation. There have been so many studies with all kinds of opinions on what the best propagation practices are. Over the years, we've played around with different growing systems and procedures just because there are so many different ways to go about propagating seeds. We've kind of found a sweet spot with all of it and just wanted to share with you guys how we are doing it over here at FarmTech. First, we're going to start with a wedge tray, a humidity dome, and a sheet of rock wool. There's many different substrates that you can use. I prefer the rock wool just because it's clean and it gives us great consistency. Next, we're going to put the rock wool sheet into the web tray, run it under the sink to saturate it 100%. Some studies say that you should adjust your pH before saturating your sheets, just because the pH coming out of the sink is probably higher than it should be. We've run side-by-side studies here with adjusting the pH and not adjusting the pH, and really, we found no significant difference with it. So just to save on time and money here, we just run it underneath the sink, and we find that to be just fine too. We do use the clear humidity domes, just not on the top like they're intended to, but we use them on the bottom. Just because we do them out here on the table, we don't want to make a big mess everywhere. You do want to wash your hands or wear gloves before you sow seeds, just to ensure that you're not going to contaminate the seeds. So once you've washed your hands, you're able to just dump a little bit of seed into your hand. We like to dump it into our hand instead of grabbing each seed out of the jar, just so we don't contaminate the seeds that are in the jar. Next, we just take a seed, drop it in the little hole, and that's all there is to it. Stop back to learn about the next step in our propagation process.